Hello guys, welcome to Code with Raj. This is Rajaniraiyn. Today I'm gonna tell you about how to create your own programming language. Let's get started. Many of you have already familiarized with many programming languages out there. For example, you may know Python, or else you may know JavaScript, C++, or any other languages. But the important thing is, only very few people who knows the programming languages knows how each and every programming languages works. For example, any programming languages have its own Hello World program. The purpose of the Hello World program is to create or is to output Hello World in the console or primary output device. But have you ever think of how our code, the syntax code which is converted or which how it get processed and why it's get output for this particular kind of code? So it's a fascinating question. To create a programming language from scratch, we need to know how actually the pre-existing languages are there. So let's talk about the history of programming languages. The history of programming languages starts from zeros and ones. So it's a machine code. So the programming language is actually starts from machine code. So each and every commands that we tell to the computer should be ones and zeros. Till now, it's the same machine code is used for modern computers as well. The evolution is we have some kind of converters which converts some particular kind of human-readable code to a machine-understandable code like machine code. So the first evolution of such kind of human understandable code is assembly language. So this kind of languages nowadays is used only in the process of manufacturing. So they use these kind of assembly programming language to create some kind of basic stuffs. Then we have some kind of other languages like basic. So basic COBOL. So these kind of languages were successors to assembly language. Assembly languages meant for human readability, but not that much readable like a paragraph. So the basic and the COBOL languages were meant to be more readable and more easily understandable as compared to assembly language. Then the programming languages evolved to C, then C++. C and C++ follow same kind of basic language syntax, but they are more robust and more feature-packed. Then we have Java, then Python, then many more languages. So we have many different kinds of languages as well. So for example, we have functional programming languages, we have object-oriented programming languages, we have scripting languages, we have markup languages, and many more. So it's endless. So up till date, there were thousands and thousands of languages out there. So each of them has their own pros and cons. For example, Python has some pros and cons. For example, the pro of Python is it's more easily understandable, it's more easy to maintain it even though it's a very heavy program. The important thing is it's very easily understandable, so that means the learning curve is very low in case of Python. But in case of other languages like C, the learning curve is somewhat higher as compared to Python, but the pro of it is it's much more faster as compared to other programming languages. The cons of Python is it's very slow as compared to other programming languages. So to create a programming language, so we have to understand how it works. So let me explain how a program works in Python. So actually there were other different kinds of programming languages like interpreter and complier languages. Python is interpreter language, while the C and C++ were complier languages. So let's talk about the Python. So we have a hello world syntax. So print, and it is enclosing as a hello world in a parenthesis. Then if we can add some semicolons or not, so it's an optional. So if we run this using Python interpreter, it outputs hello world in the console and sometimes exit code after it. But how it works, so let me explain. So the first of all, these kind of statements are gone through some process called lexical analysis, which is done by Lexo. Lexical analysis is kind of process, it's a process of converting these statements into somewhat more machine understandable. So we are converting it into array of tokens called lexemes. So it's very simple. So we are converting our statement into lexemes, and each lexeme consists of arrays. So it's very simple. So it's done by Alexa. Then the next role is done by parser. So the purpose of the parser is to convert these tokens or lexemes into more machine understandable or the code we write. So the next step is a complier or interpreter. So in case of Python, it is interpreter. So to make these kind of lexemes and tokens more understandable to what kind of so it says a command. So it tells some kind of commands from these kind of lexemes and tokens to the interpreter. So this process is done with parser. So after getting these kind of tokens and telling the telling the interpreter to do these commands, so the interpreter will do some kind of machine code. So that's nothing but ones and zeros and ones. Then it will call some operating system APIs, then shows the hello world in the primary output device. So likewise other languages works. So the difference between the interpreter and complier languages is nothing but, so the interpreter languages were converted line by line or just-in-time compliant languages. So the interpreter languages were also called as just-in-time compliant languages. So the just-in-time compliant languages is very simple. So they are converted line by line. So if we want to execute a program, Python program, what actually the Python interpreter does is it will convert each and every line that has to be executed one by one. But in case of compliant languages like C, the whole program has to be complied before running. So once we have complied it into some kind of machine code, then we can run the program. So that's why it's very fast as compared to the Python programming language, as we have to convert it into line by line multiple times. But here we have to compile it once during our build time. To create a programming language, we have to understand this one. So now just dig into how to create it. So before everything we have to start, we have to pre-plan how the syntax is going to be our programming language. For example, we can say the Python has a keyword called def or define to define a function. So we have many more keywords like that. So to create so we have to frame those kind of keywords. So let me create a programming language has a keyword called fn. So that's how we can define a programming language or the function. So then we have the function name, then opening and closing parentheses, enclosing the parameters or arguments. Then we have curly brackets. It's not like a Python, it's more like other kind of languages because it's very useful as compared to intentional languages. So you can say parentheses, so open curly bracket, then the functional statements or the statement that we have to execute it when calling the function, then closing curly brackets. So that's it. So we have to create some kind of tokens like what is, so that Lexer has to see this kind of string or this kind of program. Then it will say the first thing is the functional keyword, so it's a functional keyword. Then the second one is the functional name, so the functional name is this. Then the third one is the parameters or arguments, so these are the kinds of parameters are present in these for this function. Then it will say the function is starting here, these all are the statements, so it will do some kind of more lexical analysis in those statements. Then the closing of any function, so then it will parse it to the parser. The parser does is it will analyze those lexemes and create some kind of commands which the interpreter or complier could execute. So let me say we are creating uncompliant languages. So it will create space in the memory and it will convert it into other programming languages, say Python. So we are converting this into Python. So it will, once it sees the function, so it will create a defined keyword in the function, in the complier, sorry, the complied output. Then it will say create the name, then the parenthesis, then semicolons, or then the colon, then the intention, then the functional statements, then that's it. So this is how it works. So likewise we can implement, these kind of lexers, parsers, and interpreter or compilers using any languages. We can even use a JavaScript, a Python, or C, but most predominantly use languages is C because it's much more faster compared to others like the JavaScript or Java or even Python. So my personal suggestion is to use whichever languages that you are more familiar and stronger. So you have to design a lexer, then parser, then compiler or interpreter. This is how you can create a programming language from scratch, from nothing. So you have to first clearly understand how it works, then how it's gonna be, and just implement it. From the upcoming videos, I will explain you how I implement a modern programming language called Raj in JavaScript. So if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. If you want your friends to be helpful with this video, just spread the word and make sure you subscribe this channel.